Everybody, this is my first time on YouTube, my first time taping, so if it looks a little weird, let me get a little bit of experience. Maybe the future ones will be better. You may be wondering, what is this all about? Why am I on YouTube? I guess this is going to be a video journal. My name is Lourdes. I am an advocate for mental health. I have a mental health diagnosis of depression and anxiety, and this is the face of it. Do I look any different than anybody else out on the street? I don't think so. I'm just like everybody else, 60 years old, children, divorced, and trying to make a go of it at Silicon Valley, which right now is really difficult because of high prices in renting. Just living here, just breathing here, it seems that you're being charged for it, and for the weather, which is absolutely beautiful. It is the end of October, October 28th, actually, and it's sunny, 80 degrees here in San Jose, California, but I don't feel it. I've been having a very difficult day. Trying to deal with this depression, which has hit me hard. Switched jobs. Insurance, although I have it, is pretty expensive for what my specialized needs are. It seems that if you are diagnosed with, if you have a mental health diagnosis, you have to see a specialist. And a specialist costs more than seeing your primary care physician. Seeing a therapist is considered a special, so that means that it's a specialist that requires more payment. The meds, well, you can figure out a way to pay meds, but how do you find a way to pay a specialist? So that is what depression is, worrying about when something's going to be able to come through so that your life is a little bit easier. Hiding everything, hiding what you feel from those closest to you because you don't want to burden them. Because, of course, you don't have depression. It's just that you're having a difficult time right now. Or you're getting like this because you want me to give you money. Or you're getting like this because you want me to take over your life. And I'll run it for you because you don't know how to do it. And that's not the truth, you know? We just want somebody to listen to us, to guide us in a moment where we're feeling so much pain, where we feel that no matter what we do, we're doing something wrong because we're not good enough. Where you get to a certain age where people say you're too old, even though you may have what we say in Spanish, ganas. Yeah, I want to keep going. There's so many things that I want to do. But being depressed makes it even more difficult. So my thought is to keep a journal, a video journal. If you care to see it, you can see it. If you decide that I'm just somebody who's wallowing in because of bad decisions, that's fine. So be it. But a lot of times when you're in full-blown depression and you don't stop and take a moment for yourself, you do make bad decisions, and this is what happens. But I do know one thing. There's a very special person out there who calls me, talks to me, listens to me, more than anything else, listens to me and helps guide me through these tough moments. And I don't know where I'd be without her. She's like my, I call her my sister from another mother. And it's friends like that that help pull you through. So after a little talk, I've decided to take a moment for myself, take a step back from certain things that I've been doing in my life, and just take care of myself. Love myself. Because if I don't, I won't get out of here. And the depression will only get worse. So I'm happy to say that today I was able to take my dog for a walk, take out the trash and start doing my laundry. And, you know, for somebody with depression, that's a big accomplishment. So I feel really good for myself. Y para los que no entendieron lo que dije, este va a ser un diario virtual de video de lo que es la vida de una persona con depresión, con ansiedad, algo que es difícil para todos los que están alrededor, pero más difícil para uno, porque lo calla, lo esconde, no quiere que nadie sepa, porque entonces esos sentimientos de que uno no vale nada se vuelven peor, porque hay gente que no puede entender lo que es la depresión. Quiero seguir ayudando a los que están con algún diagnóstico de salud mental, porque quiero que al ver lo que yo estoy pasando, entiendan lo que sus familiares pasan. Esto no es fácil, es algo muy difícil y se necesita tener y contar con alguien con quien uno pueda hablar, que siente que no lo van a juzgar, que saben lo que es escuchar sin juzgar, sin querer dar una solución, sin querer arreglar las cosas, porque nadie lo puede arreglar más que uno. Y al tener a alguien que pueda escuchar, sirve mil veces más que cualquier medicamento, cualquier terapeuta. Sí, en el momento está difícil vivir en el Valle de Silicón, en San José, California, es muy difícil. Te cobran aquí hasta por el clima, que por cierto, hoy, 28 de octubre, está maravilloso. El sol está aquí. Estamos a una temperatura muy sabrosa. Ando en shorts, ando en una playera y ando feliz en ese aspecto. Y y a pesar de la depresión, mucha gente piensa que depresión es estar en cama y no querer hacer nada. Pero cuando uno está en depresión y quiere hacer algo, lo intenta. Así es que me felicito yo misma porque pude sacar al perro a caminar, pude salir a disfrutar un poco de este clima, pude tirar la basura que se había acumulado y pude echar a lavar mi ropa. Que para muchos de ustedes eso debe de ser algo, y por qué te felicitas por eso, si eso es lo que se debe de estar haciendo. Sin saber que cuando uno tiene depresión, es muy difícil hacer esas cosas, inclusive salir de la cama. Pero lo logré y me siento bien por eso. Pero ahora me voy a dar el permiso de tomar una pequeña siesta porque lidiar con estos sentimientos, hablar de estos sentimientos es algo muy pesado, muy difícil. Y tenemos que darnos permiso de relajarse y poder decir por el momento hasta aquí. Porque aún me tengo que levantar y tengo que cocinar. Así es que por hoy ha sido todo. Espero que aprendan algo de estos videos que, si Dios quiere, seguiré poniendo para poder enfrentarme yo misma a esta enfermedad y tomar cartas en el asunto y así poder ayudarme a mí misma, quererme, a tomar el tiempo de cuidarme yo misma y salir adelante. Los que me conocen saben a dónde me pueden encontrar. Y un abrazo muy en especial para esa persona que hoy me llamó, me escuchó, comprendió lo que yo estaba pasando y me ayudó a relajarme y a seguir adelante. Gracias y gracias por escuchar.